What's up guys, in this tutorial I will show you how to fix the procedure entry point bcrypt hash could not be located in the dynamic link library error you are getting on your Windows PC. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. The procedure entry point error usually occurs because of an outdated Microsoft DLL library or because of your antivirus and firewall blocking the .exe app from running properly. First, let's update the Microsoft DLL library by visiting the Microsoft Visual C++ Redistributable Downloads page. On this page, scroll down and download the correct redistributable package for your system architecture. For most users, this will be the x64 version. The download will take a second to complete, and you can find this .exe file in your downloads folder. Double-click the downloaded file and proceed with the installation. Agree to the Microsoft License Agreement and complete the installation setup using the Install Wizard. You will be prompted to restart your PC to complete the installation. This can, in some cases, already fix the procedure entry point bcrypt hash could not be located in the dynamic link library error you are getting on your Windows PC. If the problem persists, then make sure that your McAfee antivirus application is currently disabled. Your antivirus can cause the error you are getting, and disabling or reinstalling the antivirus application has helped fix this error for many users. Lastly, make sure to run the System File Checker tool to repair missing or corrupted Windows files. Open up your command prompt as an admin by searching for cmd and selecting Run as Administrator. On this window, use the command sfc/scannow. It can take up to a couple of minutes to scan and replace corrupted Windows files on your PC. After using the command, the procedure entry point error will be fixed. These steps and more information will be available in my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.